Detour.
Niles. Niles. Tell him to come to the night.
He said, look at you. It's okay.
Go to Mima. Mima.
Thank you.
Friends, be married to this man.
Saint Patrick and Supreme Mother.
Take your right hand. On behalf of Jason and Angie, I'd like to thank all the family and friends that have taken time out of your schedule today to be a witness to this ceremony in the presence of our Lord God Almighty of the joining together in this marriage ceremony. Let us pray. Lord, we come to you at this time. So thankful for this man and this woman that have come together to be united in holy matrimony according to your word. As we've gathered here as witnesses today, it's in the name of your precious son, Jesus. And we ask that your spirit will be here. We know that this ceremony is recorded in the heavens. We thank you for this opportunity to share this joy. In the wonderful name of our Lord, we pray. Amen.
Amen.
You may be seated.
Would you do that so I can get him?
Dearly beloved, we're gathered here today to celebrate in joining Jason Howard Cripps and Angela Cornelia Taylor in the holy bonds of matrimony. In the years that they have been together, their love and understanding of each other has grown and matured. And now they have decided to live their lives together as husband and wife. The Word of God says that a man will leave his mother and father and cleave unto his wife, and they shall become one flesh. Jason and Angie. Seek from within yourselves the serenity to accept the things that you cannot change, the courage to change the things that you must, and most importantly, the wisdom to know the difference. Live each day, one day at a time. Enjoying your time together, one moment at a time. Seek the wisdom of experience, learning all that you can from each other. Accept your hardships as building blocks of experience. Strive to make as many things right as humanly possible in your lives together, that you may be happy in the life that you share from this day forward. Love is patient. Love is kind. Love does not envy or boast. It's not arrogant or rude. It does not insist on its own way. In 35 years of marriage, I can say it does not insist on its own way. You'll have things that you'll have to come together, but they'll be better for the both. It's not irritable or resentful. It does not rejoice at wrongdoing, but it rejoices with the truth. Love bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, and endures all things. If anyone here today knows of a reason why this couple should not be wed, or if someone happens to know that the bride or groom has any outstanding warrants, unpaid fines, truck abandonment, or anything else under the EAC that we're not aware of, please speak now or forever. Don't go to the law. That's why we turned the lights off out there. I can't see the hands. Jason and Angie have decided to present one another with a ring as a symbol of their love for one another. Do you have your rings? You know, when they made these rings, they joined two ends together. And now, they're just a complete circle. Without a microscope or whatever they use, there's no way to tell where these were joined. We know that today, Flag Day, would be a good way to remember your anniversary. June 14th, 2008. 2014, two lives are joined together. And from that point forward, there should be no separation. And every time you look at these rings, don't just let it be a reminder of the other hand, but let it be a reminder of these vows that we hold sacred and that you're about to repeat to one another, and that this is a symbol of your love towards one another. I would just like to go ahead and, if you place your hands on here, I'd just like to say a short blessing on these rings. Dear God, we know that these are precious metal, and that God, Jason and Angie are exchanging them as they exchange their vows. I pray, Lord, that it'll be a reminder always of what has taken place here today. Let them be blessed. Lord, let them be blessed every time that they look at these. And let it be a reminder of your love for them, and that with you in the center of their lives will always be together. In Jesus' name, amen. That be moved. Do you, Jason, take Angie to be your lawfully wedded wife, to honor and cherish for better or for worse, in sickness and in poor living conditions, for poor or even poorer, until death and trucking do you part? Jason, please repeat after me. Here you take it. I, Jason, promise you, Angie, that I will be your husband from this day forward.
That I will be your husband from this day forward.
To be faithful.
To be faithful.
And honest in every way.
And honest in every way.
To honor the faith and trust you place in me.
Honor the faith and trust you place in me.
To love and respect you.
To love and respect you.
In your success and failures.
In your success and failures.
To make you laugh.
To make you laugh.
And be there when you cry. To care for you in sickness and in health.
Care for you in sickness and in health.
To be your companion.
To be your companion.
And your friend.
And your friend.
On this journey that we make together.
On this journey that we make together.
In the place of God. Do you, Angela, take Jason to be your lawfully wedded husband, to honor, cherish, for better or for worse, in sickness and in poor living conditions, and poor and even poorer, until death or trucking you depart? Please repeat after me. I, Angie, promise you, Jason, that I will be your wife,
that I will be your wife
from this day forward.
From this day forward.
To be faithful,
to be faithful,
and honest in every way,
and honest in every way.
To honor the faith and trust you place in me,
to honor the faith and trust you place in me.
To love and respect you,
to love and respect you.
In your success,
in your success,
and in failures.
In failures.
To make you laugh,
to make you laugh.
To be there when you cry,
to be there when you cry.
To care for you in sickness and in health,
to care for you in sickness and in health.
To be your companion,
to be your companion.
And your friend. On this journey that we make together.
On this journey that we make together.
We're going to have one more prayer before I pronounce being man and wife. I know y'all may think there's a lot of prayer, but I want to let you know there's a lot of prayer that needs to go into a marriage. There's a lot of ups and lots of downs. But the wonderful thing is that the downs can never compare to the ups when you're together. In Christ and the center of the marriage. Let's all pray. Lord, we come to you right now, Jesus. Dear God, I believe that all of heaven stands still as we unite this man and this woman. We ask, God, that they will always turn to you for guidance and turn to one another. Let them know, Lord Jesus, that they have family, friends, and a place that we call church that they can come to with anything that arises. This is not something that they have to do just on their own. But God, there are those that love them and will support them, dear Jesus. And we just ask, God, that as we pray, that you would give them the leadership and guidance and keep them bound together through your love. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Now, by the power vested in me by the state of Tennessee, that which was ordained today, let no man, woman, dispatcher, or DOT officer put asunder. You may now change your logbook status from on duty, not driving, to sleeper berth. I pronounce you husband and wife. You may kiss your bride. For the first time on this earth and sounded in heaven, I want to introduce to you Mr. and Mrs. Jason Chris.